Hey guys, thanks for stopping by Greg's Beer Reviews. Today we're going to do a local beer brewed here in the valley. This is Roanoke Railhouse's Broken Knuckle IPA. This is a 7% ABV beer. IBUs on this beer is 82. The commercial description on this, it says this is one hopped up beer. We use six different types of hops and our unique hop burst process to make this tasty IPA. Broken Knuckle has a wonderful hop aroma and flavor, subdued malt and balanced bitterness with a stunning copper color. I know some of the guys and the owner of this brewery, and they try to do a good job. Like I said, a lot of times there are influences from upper management that influence what the brewer actually is able to brew or allowed to brew. I do know that. But that's the way it is with most of the operations in the brewery, is that the head brewer is not the owner. You get some input in from upper management of what they want done. So, it is what it is in the brewing business. So, with that being said, let's get on with this. The food pairing for this is your typical IPA. Cuisine is your curd and your Thai food. Your cheeses are peppery, pepper jack, Monterey, sharp, blue, cheddar. Your more pungent cheeses, Gorgonzola, Limburger. And the meat is poultry, fish, shellfish, and salmon. And like I always say, I'll add grilled meat to that. Burgers, pizza, chops, steaks, hot dogs. I mean, if you're an IPA fan, you like IPAs, just about everything. And the glassware is a pint becker, a nonic tumbler, a mug, stein, or side ale. I got the pint glass today. And being an IPA, it is not recommended for extended cellaring, so let's get it in the glass, guys. All right. Not a large head on that fairly aggressive pour there. A little less than a finger of head, and it is a nice copper color. Deep amber to copper color. I can see the bulb right through it. It is a fairly clear beer. Looks pretty good in the glass. Let's get a nose on it. It's got a nice hoppy profile to it, but I am getting the malt through there though. For six types of hops, I don't think it's quite as hoppy as it could be or should be, but they're there. And the bottle should have a date on it, but the bottle here actually says it's 7.5 ABV. And it says enjoyed by 10/2014. So they want you to have this by October of 2014, which we are within those dates, and it's when it says enjoyed by. A lot of times, a lot of different beer companies have different shelf lives. They might have 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. I've even heard of some IPAs having a year shelf life, and I disagree with that. I kind of like to have the bottle on date more so than the enjoyed by date. So you never know how long they're giving a shelf life to the beer when it has enjoyed by usually. But anyway, it is what it is. For six different hops, it's just not blowing my nose off my face here with that many different hops. So let's give it a taste and see what we got. Cheers, everybody. Not giving any of the alcohol. It's a well-made beer. But the hops are just not jumping out to me like an IPA that's had six different hops put in there. So I don't know if they're dry hopping it or not. I do know the head brewer there, and he brews some pretty good home brews. So I don't know how, I hate to say this, but I don't know how much his hands are tied with what he's brewing. If they're telling him what recipes he used, and he's not allowed to do any kind of tweaking with that. So, behind closed doors, you don't know what's going on. But anyway, as far as I'm concerned, it's not a hop bomb. It's not a hop monster. There are a lot of IPAs out there that have a little more hoppiness to them than what this is. I mean, the Betty and the Hangar 24 that we did the other days were much more hoppier than what this is. So. But it's right out of the fridge. Let's let it warm up a little bit, let the other half taste it, and we'll come back and we'll do the final chug on this one. Right now, I'm not blown away, so we'll let it warm up just a hair and see where it ends up. Hey guys, I'm back. I got a little bit left here. I'm a little disappointed with this, knowing the head brewer down there, but evidently I've tasted some of his beers, and his beers are pretty damn tasty. So like I said earlier, there are probably some outside influences, like upper management, that has some influence on what he can brew and what recipe he can use. So let's do the final chug on this one. What I would consider this, guys, is a transitional beer. If you've been drinking the macro lagers or some pails and you want to get into something just a tad more hoppier, this may be your first choice to go to if you're in this area. They distribute all over Virginia. I don't know how far out of Virginia they go, but there are a lot more hoppier beers than this. And like I said, having an enjoy by date on, I don't know exactly how long it's been in the bottle, whether it's been in there a month, 2, 3 months, 4 months. And that has an effect on how an IPA tastes, guys. The fresher it is, the more hop profile you're going to get on it. So with that being said, it's above average beer, but to me, it is not an outstanding IPA. More like a transitional beer. I mean, I've even had some pale ales. Dale's Pale and Sierra Nevada's Pale is more hoppier than what this is, and they're pale ales. Not quite as bitter, but they have a bigger hop profile. So, with that being said, guys, I'm going to give it a 5, which is a B-. It is an above-average beer. Very well-made beer. I'm not getting any of the 7.5% alcohol on it, so... if you drink a 6-pack of these, you're going to have your buzz going on, no doubt about it. So, with that being said, let's go over and see what everybody else has written or said. And Beer Advocate says 76, which is okay. I think it's slightly better than that. If I was putting a numeric rating on it, I'd probably give it an 81 or an 82, somewhere in that area. And over to Rate Beer. Whew, Rate Beer's not kind at all. Rate Beer says 53 overall and 28 in the style. I got a problem with the style calling it an IPA, and it's not very hoppy, even though they say they use 6 different hops. So it is what it is. Glad I tried it, but it's not what I consider an outstanding IPA. It's a good beer, but it's not outstanding. So with that being said, if you've had this one, the Broken Knuckle IPA from Roanoke Warehouse, let me know what you think. Let's go see what's in the fridge some more, guys.